Welcome back. With this video, we start our discussions on stochastic processes in biology. Until now, we have used ordinary differential equations to understand the dynamics of a system. We have a system of ODEs that represents the rules of time evolution of the system, and we have the initial condition. With these two information, rule of time evolution and the initial state of the system, we can exactly predict the state of the system in future. This type of system or process is called a deterministic system. But what if either we do not know all the rules of the system or the initial state or both? Then we will have uncertainty about the future state of the system. We will not be able to predict the future state of the system exactly. We will call these type of systems or processes as stochastic systems or stochastic processes. So stochastic systems are opposite of deterministic one. We are arguing that our ignorance is giving rise to the uncertainty. But can some system be inherently stochastic? That means whatever you try, you can never be able to get rid of the uncertainty about that system. This question has bothered us for long. It is mostly accepted that certain systems are inherently stochastic, such as the radioactive decay of an isotope. However, in this course, we will not deal with any such inherently stochastic system. We will focus only on uncertainties arising out of our ignorance. Let's take two examples to understand our definition of a stochastic process. First, the coin toss, a textbook example. Coin toss is a stochastic process. We cannot predict exactly whether we will get a head or a tail in a toss. There is uncertainty. But if we know the exact orientation of the coin and all the forces applied to it, we should be able to predict the outcome of a coin toss, at least in principle. In fact, you can make a coin flipper that would toss a coin with quite a predictable outcome. I am not assuring an exact outcome, there will be some minor variations beyond our control, still we could make the system quite predictable. So the uncertainty that we have about the outcome of a coin toss is because of our ignorance of the system. Take another textbook example, the Brownian motion of a pollen. Water molecules collide with the pollen repeatedly and the pollen moves haphazardly on the surface. The movement is unpredictable. We are uncertain in which direction it will move at the next moment. However, what if we know the exact position and momentum of all water and pollen molecules? Won't we be able to predict the future movement of the pollen just by using the equations of classical mechanics? Possibly yes. However, we will prefer to avoid such a Herculean effort to know the initial states of all the molecules and to do such a huge amount of calculation. Instead, it is smarter to consider Brownian motion as a stochastic process and use probability to connect diffusion with the mean squared displacement of the pollen. A stochastic process is also called a random process. Variables in a stochastic process are random variables. For example, the number of heads obtained in 10 sequential coin tosses is a random variable. The direction of movement of a pollen in Brownian motion is also a random variable. In day-to-day conversation, random has many meanings, like desire, arbitrary, and there are many misconceptions about random processes. Some believe that there is no cause and effect relation in a random process. That's wrong. We may not know the exact cause of a random event, but that does not mean the principle of causality is invalid. Sometimes it is assumed that in a random process, everything is equally likely. That is also not true. We can have a coin that is biased to a head, still we have uncertainty about the outcome of a toss. To avoid these misconceptions, we will avoid using the phrase random processes, rather stick to the phrase stochastic process. Stochastic processes have uncertainty. However, the uncertainty increases when the system size is small. Biochemical reactions in a cell are stochastic. We never have the complete information to predict the exact behavior of a biochemical reaction inside a cell. This uncertainty increases when the number of molecules are very low. Suppose we induced a gene expression in E. coli by adding IPTG in the media. Now we count the number of copies of mRNA produced in a single E. coli cell. Mind it, in a single E. coli cell. Just now, one copy of mRNA is produced. As transcription is stochastic, we have uncertainty when the next copy of the mRNA will be produced. The time interval between the production of two mRNAs is a random variable. Therefore, the data collected from a single cell will not be smooth, but it should look like a step plot. Now check two other cells. The dynamics will be different. However, if we collect data from millions of cells and average those, we will get a smooth curve. Averaging over many observations reduces the fluctuation in data and makes the system equivalent to a deterministic system. The fluctuations observed in the data of a stochastic process is known as the noise. For this reason, a stochastic process is called a noisy process. In a stochastic process, we are chasing random variables. So we need to change the question that we ask. Take the example of transcription. If it is deterministic, we will ask, what would be the count of the mRNA after 1 hour of induction? But in a stochastic system, the count of mRNA is a random variable. So we cannot ask its exact number. Rather, we will change the question and ask, what is the probability that the count of mRNA will be n after 1 hour of induction? N can be any value. So we have to determine the probability of the system being in a particular state and predict how this probability changes with time. Here are the key points. Many biological processes are stochastic in nature. Stochasticity is opposite of determinism. For a stochastic process, we cannot predict the exact state of the system. Rather, we estimate the probability of the system to be in a particular state. Size of the system affects stochastic behavior. Systems with very low number of molecules has stochasticity. The observation in a stochastic process fluctuates. This fluctuation is called noise. So stochastic processes are noisy. That's all for this video. Thank you for learning with me.